Hello everyone, it's me, back with another video, and in this episode, I am playing some more Terraria, and as you can probably tell, I have an actual mouse now, so I'm able to do this and scroll between my inventory with the wheel real quick. So that's pretty cool, and I did some playing off of camera, and I built another house. Another star. That's nice. And I've been playing and going down in the mines and stuff and collecting stars. So in the mines I got a bunch of platinum, and I got some heart crystals, a lot more stars, and I also got this cool thing called these Hermes boots, and it pretty much allows me to do that thing that you just saw me do, where it'll pretty much make me like sprint super super fast, and it is super super cool. I also got some platinum armor, so that gives me 20 defense. I'm trying to grow some of the acorn gem like gemstone trees so that I can get a actual hook, and I also got some more bombs. I got some life crystals, and I've been farming for these fallen stars. And the most important thing that I got is this, a diamond staff, which is super, super good because of how it is a magic weapon, and it does so much damage. Look at how good that is, if I could hit. Because of how I don't have that much mana, I collected a bunch of stars. And now I am going to craft all of these up into mana crystals. I don't know the max amount, so I'm going to assume it's 10 stars, and get 8 of these because I don't want to waste these, since I can make mana stars in a bottle, and I can use that. So if I could do that, I'd like, but yeah, I don't want to end up wasting this. So yeah, now that I have a full mana, I'm pretty sure this is full because on my other character, 200 is the max I have for it. I also got some more life crystals, which there is a thing called life fruit, which gives you more HP. So that's pretty cool. I am going to go over to the Eater of Worlds. I forgot that I did not hammer that, but I should hammer that. And now I am able to just quickly run up this. I'm pretty sure that that should be like that. So yeah, now I am pretty kitted out. And I also got this when I was going underground. I got this suspicious looking eye. And what it does is it summons a boss called the Eye of Cthulhu. So yeah, that is going to be a pretty important boss that I am going to have to fight. So I'm going to sort out my inventory, get everything all set for the fight. I'm probably going to equip my diamond robe, and then if I get down to where I need to equip this, I will do that too. But yeah, so I'm not going to make an arena, because arenas are for casuals. So I'm just going to go in with my current stuff. There is also a traveling merchant. And those guys are not exactly common, so I am going to want to talk to this guy, because the thing is, they only stay for a little while. So a DPS meter, that is pretty nice. There we go. Alright, I'm going to get this, and now it will tell me how much damage I do per second, so that is pretty nice. And I might as well also talk to my my normal merchant. So, these are the new pylons. I don't know how to use them, but that's pretty cool. And he also will sell me potions. So, I am going to sell some of my items to him, and then I will buy some more of that. Alright, so I'm going to buy some potions from you. I'm going to get 30 of them, then give those to you. Then I'm also going to get some mana potions, since I'm going to need them. I can get 50 mana potions, so that's pretty nice. I will see you in the corruption because of YouTube editing magic. And with the power of editing magic, I am in the corruption, just like that. So I am going to hop into one of these chasms, and I am going to fight the giant worm. So yeah, I'm going to place down some of these flowers because it increases your movement speed. Then I'm also going to place down some of the campfires, life regen, and some stars, because mana regen. So yeah, and I made this, okay, I almost thought I was dead. I made this small gateway thing so that I could easily glitch my way into the corruption. I say easily, but it took me a while. I might play that clip right now. I might not, since it did take a while. But now that I have bombs, I can easily just throw that there and just sit here. And I know that the bombs do hurt you, so I'm going to try to stay away from it. But yeah, now that I am all like kitted out and geared up for battle, I am going to summon this guy. So I am just going to set down some of my campfires and all, stars and bottles, yada yada yada. Explode all of this so that I can easily break all of this. And a musket. So once you smash 3 of the orbs, that means that it will spawn 36 damage. That is a lot of damage. I'm going to have that on my 4th slot. Now I can, oh dang it, so close. Break this orb. What will I get? Ooh, a vile thorn. Oh, it's broken. That's minus 30 damage. This would have been so good since it's ranged, but now it only does 3 damage. This would have been so perfect. Alright, there we go. Oh, another musket, but it is not as good as the godly musket. Uh-oh. So yeah, this is the Eater of Worlds here. He's pretty strong, so I don't want to throw down too hard with him, but I can also take out my mace and do things like this, and it will do a lot to him. But the thing is, because of how it is a giant worm, it can split up into segments and it will still be alive. Unfortunately, I am getting taken out so hard right now. I am so dead. Goodbye. Oh god. Owie, owie, owie. Just let me live. I'm so dead. Goodbye. Change the world. My final message. Why is this guy abusing me? Okay, give me that help. That one right there. That help. I need it. Come on, help! Carry me, please! Come on! I am so dead. Ah, dang it. Well, I got pretty far. It's just I was stuck in that stupid chasm. Ah. Once it is night, I will summon the Eater of Worlds, or not Eater of Worlds, Cthulhu, and I might be able to actually create the summoning item for the Eater of Worlds. If I can, then I'm just going to do that and fight it again. But yeah, I really wish that I was able to kill that worm. But I was not. What does chain do? I don't know why I just trapped it. Alright, well, with YouTube magic, it will be night. Oh! I summon it! Okay. Okay, let me move my map. So, yeah, this is the Eye of Cthulhu. He's, the big baddie. I set up a thing over this way. Yeah, so now I have all of my buffs up on this hilltop. Oh god, this is an interesting fight. Not once have I exactly fought with a giant eyeball before, but... Alright, so this gives me 35 damage per second. Almost 40. Oh, no, I think that probably was because of the critical strike thing I got. But then if I use my musket... gives me higher numbers. So here's his second form. He rips off his pupil, I guess. And, psych, he's a mouth now. So, he has this one very bad attack where he does that. Except because of how it's expert mode, he has that, but instead of it being a normal attack, it's pretty much that attack, but on steroids. So, yep, that's it. That's the attack. Stop right there. Alright. Okay, so this is going pretty easy for me. I say as I'm pretty much dying. Oh god, that did so much damage! No, stop! You, sir! I'm trying to stay near where I can get my buffs, but... No! Stop it! No! This freaking idiot. Nope. No! No! Fallen Star, help me! No! No! It was so close too! I was so close! Alright then, I guess I am going to go back into the corruption to try to fight the Eater of Worlds again, because I am not going to admit defeat. I will beat one of thy bosses in this episode. Thy rhino will never give up. I got some of my lenses, and I got another eye. And this time, I'm not gonna die. So, that's gonna be a thing. It cost me 6 of the lenses in order to be able to get this, so hopefully I won't die. I'm going to see if I can get any potions that will help me. And I'm going to do that strat when he's in the charging phase, because doing it right now won't help me out too much. But yeah, I'm currently just kind of praying for dear life. So yeah, now I'm able to see, oh god, where all of these guys are without me having to take damage for it. So that's pretty good. If I could get him in a position to where when he does the spinning, he will do it in a place where I can hit him a bunch, that would be nice. How much am I at? I should not do a heal yet. God, please stop. I think he's about to do his spinning. Almost. There we go. I well and truly expected that to do a lot more. Come on, do a lot more damage. Okay, I'm going away from where I should be. But this is fine. Okay, so now I'll be able to see him come up. I think that this is helping him more than it is helping me. Okay. Okay, this is not very good. Please stay away from me. Oh god, stay away. This is how I died last time. No! Why is dancing playing? Stop it, Apple Music! I gotta get copyright claimed! This is not the time. Stop it! Okay, there we go. I don't know why that was just happening. Stop! Load! No! Stop it! You're so close! You're so close! No! That could have killed me! Come on! Why is my mouse cursor showing? Just die already! No! Stop it! No! I was so close. I'm gonna make some potions. So that I can hopefully survive it next time. I'm going to go onto the Terraria wiki and find out all of the potions I can make that will help me. Going to craft up a bunch of them. And this will mean that I will survive the fight next time. Okay, so I am back from trying to get all of that researching of how to get those potions, and then I got them. So, took me a while, and I got 5 of each, except for these burgers, but those are just drops, and except for these endurance potions, because those take fish, and fishing, I don't really like to do it. So, I just stopped at that, and yeah. And I also got some more gems, which is good because now I could make more gem corns, but I am not going to do that because I now have 15. And there were some more down there, but I just got to here, so now I can make a large sapphire. I'm joking, of course, the sapphire hook. It's so good. So now I'm able to do that. And that is so, so nice. Now, of course, you have to throw it right, of course, but it's going to help me with the boss fight so much because I'm going to be able to just grapple down and say that the Eye of Cthulhu is about to charge into me. I can easily just bam. Oh god, well, I lagged there, so that doesn't count. But I can easily just bam, move out of the way. And then they'll charge up there, and I will be left unaffected. So, while I am waiting to get into the corruptions, I might as well run you through all of the buffs that I have. So, first off, I have a burger. Gives you good improvements to all stats. That's pretty nice. I have some more hunter potions, because of how the Eater of Worlds burrows underground, it will be very, very good to have, to like be able to see it while it is underground, because then I will know where it's about to like emerge and all of that.
What is this? This looks like a thing. Nope, it is not.
Then I have an iron skin potion. Just costs some iron, and it increases defense by 8. So that's very nice. Endurance potion reduces damage taken by 10, which is very, very nice. But because of how it uses fish, that is a lot. So I only got a couple. Then some thorn potions, which is good because now I will be able to deal damage. So even while I'm getting destroyed, that means that the bosses are also getting destroyed. I have a regen potion, which will stack with this regeneration, since as it says increases life regen, and this gives more life regen, and of course just the normal life regen and the life regen from the campfire, so a lot of regenerating. This increases magic damage by 20%, that is very nice. Swiftness potion, that is very good, 25 increased speed, which will stack with this, 5% increased speed, and 3% increased speed, and this will also give me the like running thing when you run for a bit. So yeah, that's also pretty good. And then mana regen potion, pretty much just like this, except for mana. Okay, so I don't know if I have to be in the underground corruption for this to work. Hopefully I can use it while in the above corruption, because I don't really like fighting in the underground corruption that much. It is much more cramped. Ooh, I can zoom in and zoom out. That is very nice. But yeah, it's a lot more cramped and I can't do much, but with this I can. So let's see, will it work? It sure will. Press my G key to activate all of my buffs. And now I can proceed to destroy thy eater of worlds. I don't get my other buffs from the things that I have down there, but that is fine. I can live with it. So yeah, I'm going to be able to use my mace a lot in this fight because it will help out. Why are they shooting at me? It is a worm. I don't know how a worm can shoot, but I guess that's just it now. So yeah, I'm going to try to aim for the head because, as we all know, you should have gone for the head. But then again, the Eater of Worlds also splits. So yeah, it will help a lot to actually go for the head, because then I won't have to deal with fighting a thousand small Eater of Worlds or just one large Eater of Worlds. So yeah, I don't want to die, but I feel like that part was a bit obvious. And yeah, it's not too difficult just yet, and because of how it is a worm, I am able to do things like this with my mace and do a lot of damage to it, not even doing that much to me. So I feel like I am going to easily win this battle. However, it is now doing a lot more damage. I don't know why, but that is the thing now. So, oh god, its vile spit is where most of its damage is coming from. So, I want to avoid that as much as I really can. I say as I am getting completely targeted by it. Can it hit underwater? It sure can. Oh no! 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 Gonna make an arena. Not make an arena. Arenas are for casuals. Okay, so I just realized that whole time that my mic was because of how I use headphones, I realized that I didn't have both headphones in. So I hope that my mic sounded fine there. If not, then I'll just suffer. Okay, I am back now. So, I am going to try again, except summon it in the underground corruption, because then I will be able to actually fight it. Because I feel like it'll be easier, because in the underground corruption, it will be a lot more tight and compact, which the Eater of Worlds is not very good at because of how it's a giant worm. So yeah, let's try this again. Press my buffs and start shooting at it. Alright, so let's see. You wanna spawn up there? I will let that happen. So, now that I am able to use my grapple, I forgot that I had it because I didn't have it beforehand. But now that I can actually grapple, I am going to be using this a lot more. And it will help out so, so much. And, uh-oh. Come on. There we go. So hopefully I won't die. And, yeah. I feel like I am going to do a lot better this time. Now that I can actually do damage to it without me just completely getting ruined. Stop, you eater of souls. You eater of worlds, one of you. So yeah, once it's all compacted like this, I can throw down my mace like that and crank out a lot of damage. Like right there, that is a lot of damage right there. This guy is all on his own. That means that I will attempt to kill him, but I will fail. And then I will try to do this guy. You can die right this freaking moment. Alright, so now I'm going to swing my mace all over here, do a bunch of damage to it. Then I'm going to do that, causing even more damage. So yeah. This is a lot, but I worked hard for these buffs. I feel like I got this. I just have to be doing this right. What just happened there? It's times like this when I am really glad that the gem stabs are able to shoot without me having to furiously click my mouse over and over again. Uh-oh, how much gold do I have? Ooh, wow, 6, that's pretty nice. Uh-oh. So yeah, look at how much damage that just did. Alright. Yeah, this is a lot of damage to it. Just need to kill it. It's doing a lot to me too, but this is fine because the Eater of Worlds is a casual. Come on. If I can live for 20 more seconds, then I'll be able to heal. And I feel like I have this fight in the bag, but knowing my luck, I will die. Very soon. Like, I will die when it has one segment left. I really hope that editor me didn't just put text up as foreshadowing there. Because if so, then that means that I'm going to die. So, I guess you'll know if I'm going to die in this fight or not, based off of editor me. How did that literally not even hit? Okay, heal, just because I can. Okay, how much more? There we go. So, because of how I play expert mode, because after all, I'm an expert. Because of how I'm playing expert mode, it means that I get this cool little treasure bag here. And it gives you a special item depending on the guy that you kill. So, I'm going to open it. And it gave me an arcane worm staff. It reduces the damage that I take by 17. So that is very nice, because minus 17 damage, it's pretty much like this endurance potion right here. I feel like I will get rid of my... feel like my jellyfish necklace. I'm going to get rid of this. Nope, not my Hermes boots. Jellyfish necklace. And because of how it's arcane, it gives me more of that boost. So that is pretty nice. So now I can shoot a lot of mana. What are you there? Blue slime. Alright then. Okay, so because of how I just beat that, it means that I am now able to progress to the next thing that I have. Steam Knight. Hopefully this is enough to give me like a full set of everything. I'm really praying it is. Because Terraria things are expensive. So let's see what I can get. I can get... Is this good? No, it's not. How much does this cost? 15, 25, 20. Quick math. Oh my god, why are these so expensive? It's gonna cost me like almost all of mine. I can't tell. But yeah, I guess I'm going to go down into the depths of hell. So yeah, I hope that you enjoy this. And if you did, then please do leave a like and subscribe. Because, I mean, you watch to this point, and only people who like my content will watch to this point. One of those people includes you. So you might as well subscribe since you're just doing yourself a favor. Because then you'll get notified of whenever I upload. So yeah. Make sure you like, subscribe, all of that. Maybe even share it with a friend if you really, really want to share the love. Yeah, do that, please. I need to get my videos recommended because then maybe one day I can actually go somewhere with this. So yeah, what? Oh my god, there's more of it down there. So yeah, I hope you did enjoy, and bye!